So this is the X550 PB. If you're going to do HUD lead paint, that's the model you have to use. That's the model that's got the PCS. You can add other stuff to it, like metals in soil, dust wipes, lead in soil, alloy testing. You can add all kinds of stuff to it, but make sure the base model you get is the X550 PB, because that's the one that's got the PCS. Very important if you're going to do lead testing. All right, so that's the model. That's what it does. Let's give you a quick tour of this device before we talk about the technology. So first thing that happens is you turn it on, and automatically it forces you to do a PCS Cal check. The way we do that is you take your handy dandy NIST 1.04 standard, put the device on it, and you see on that screen it says PCS Cal pass. It also said one of three. The PCS requires three consecutive 1.0 tests. There's the second one. Here's the third one. I see it says three of three. And now you're done. So you've got your three tests. They've all been right at 1.0. The range is 0.8 to 1.2, so we're easily within the range. That's a pass, and you're ready to test. If you're doing New York City testing, you have to do the same thing on the blank and the software set up for New York City testing if you want to do that. And that's how the device works. So let's talk about how does it work. What we've done is we've replaced the radioactive isotope. So instead of radioactive materials inside this gun decaying away to produce the radiation to measure the lead in the paint, we've replaced all that with an X-ray tube. An X-ray tube is just simply a high voltage and an electric current that makes X-rays. And if you go to your doctor's office or your dentist's office and you get an X-ray, all those devices use X-ray tubes. So we've taken that X-ray tube technology with our partner, we've miniaturized it, put it in this device. And people say, oh, those X-ray tubes fragile, blah, blah, blah. They're not fragile. X-ray tubes have been in this kind of devices for almost 20 years. And they've been in scrap yards and oil fields and all kinds of places where they get beat up all the time. They're a very rugged little device, these X-ray tubes. And it's just been a relatively new invention that we could put them into a device and get a HUD PCS. So that's the key. It's an X-ray tube and it's an X-ray detector. That combination and a good algorithm, and you can get your PCS and use it for lead paint testing. So this device has plenty of penetrating power. Just to do a few quick shots here. So let's just shoot a couple. We'll shoot the surface lead. This is easy. Just to give you an idea how it works, you pull the trigger, couple seconds. It says positive or negative based on the PCS. So this was one of the longer tests you'll have, about 3 or 4 seconds, because this is a 0.7 standard testing against a 1.0 action level. So it'll take a little longer, so that precision is such that you know it's below one. That's one of the longest tests you'll have with this device, is when you've got a negative, but it's close to the action level. And again, that's about 3 seconds. The device never gets any slower. Okay, we've done the PCS Cal check. Now, I want to show you my favorite little demonstration. And the reason we do this is because we have a competitor that likes to say that the X-ray tube device is only good for surface lead and can't read buried lead. And that is simply untrue. First of all, there's no way this device would have gotten such a good PCS if it could only read surface lead. The PCS testing looks at hundreds of materials from real world houses and samples that have been painted many, many times over. So that is a great test of any device. But let's just do something to show you what we're talking about here. So let's start. This is a NIST 1.6 milligram. We'll stick it on a piece of wood. This is a surface lead test. Let's shoot it. And this is the PCS mode. So as soon as it knows it's above one with a certain degree of statistical confidence, it ends the test. So you see it reads 1.5. Let's do it again. 1.4. Let's do it again. All right, you get the idea. 1.4, 1.5, 1.6. It knows it's above one, and it's going to stop the test. That's how the device works in this PCS mode. So now let's do this. Let's take that piece of material. Let's put it inside this book. All right, so it's gonna be, see if I can show this on the camera, inside this thick piece of plastic. And on top of that, it's gonna be this NIST blank, which is a chunk of paint. And then we're gonna fold it over. You got some metal here, you fold it over. You got this thick cover of the notebook, which is hard and metallic-y. We'll put that over there. So we've got a lot of material on top of that 1.6 standard. Now let's just go and take a test here. All right. It'll take a little bit longer because the signal's a little attenuated. But there you go. All right, now it says 2.0, positive. All right, so do it again. There you go, 2.0 or 1.9 instead of 2.0. Repeatable and positive. So that 1.6 that we on the surface, we easily read it through all that thick material. We didn't miss any buried lead. In fact, this nice little feature on the device called the depth factor shows how when lead, the deeper the lead is buried under non-lead paint, the larger that number. So that's what that's all about. So there you go. This thing has no problem on buried lead. We've eliminated the isotope, and we've got a great PCS. So don't believe that nonsense when you hear it out there. Thank you.